Hi everyone, today I am going to talk about X-ray crystallography. We know that X-ray crystallography is a very important technique for the structure determinations. Wouldn't it be nice if you could simply look at a molecule and see its structure with your eyes? Determining the three-dimensional shape of an object around you is easy. You just look at it. Let your eyes focus the light rays reflected from the object and let your brain assemble the data into a recognizable image. If the object is small, you use microscope and let the microscope lens focus the visible light. Unfortunately, there is a limit to what you can see, even with the best optical microscope, called the diffractions limit. You can't see anything smaller than the wavelength of light you are using for the observations. Visible light has wavelength of several hundred nanometer, but atom in molecules have dimensions on the order of 0.1 nanometer. Thus, to see a molecule, whether a small one in the laboratory or a large complex enzyme with a molecular weight in the tens of thousands, you need wavelength in the 0.1 nanometer range, which correspond to X-rays. Let's say that we want to determine the structure in shape of an enzyme or other biological molecules. The technique used is called X-ray crystallography. First, the molecule is crystallized, which is often turns out to be most difficult and time consuming part of the entire process. And a small crystal with a dimension of 0.4 to 0.5 mm on its longest axis is glued to the end of the glass fiber. The fiber and attached crystal are then mounted in an instrument called an X-ray diffractometer, which consists of a radiation source, a simple positioning and orienting device can rotate the crystal in any directions, a detector and a controlling computer. Once mounted in the diffractometer, the crystal is irradiated with X-rays, usually so-called copper K-alpha radiations, with a wavelength of 0.154 nanometer. When the X-ray strike the enzyme crystal, then interact with the electrons in the molecule and are scattered into a diffraction pattern, which when detected the visualized appear as a series of intense spots against a null background. Manipulation of the diffraction pattern to extract three-dimensional molecular data is a complex process, but the final result is that an electron density map of the molecule is produced. Because electrons are largely localized around atom, any two center of electrons density located within bonding distance of each other are assumed to represent bonded atoms, leading to a recognizable chemical structure. So, important is this structural information for biochemistry that an online database of more than 66,000 biological substances has been created, even small molecules, operated by Georgia University and funded by the US National Science Foundation. The protein data bank, PDB, is a worldwide repository for processing and distributing three-dimensional structure data for biological molecules, macromolecules. We will see how to access the PDB in chapters. Thank you.